phone. This automation is gonna blow your mind. Seriously, hear me out.
I have a trash pickup scheduled every Friday. So I get a notification on my phone to put the trash outside. And an announcement is made on my refrigerator only if I don't put the trash outside, saying,
"Announcement, tomorrow is a trash pickup day. Please put the trash outside. If you miss this, your house is going to stink."
Okay, how the heck does Alexa know trash bins are not outside? I have a microcontroller connected to a distance sensor which detects the distance between these cute eyes and the trash bins. If the distance is less than 3 feet, then it notifies me every 30 minutes until the distance is detected more than 5 feet. Once I put the bins out, announcement on my refrigerator says,
"Good job on putting the trash outside. You are truly a hero."
I made this automation so smart enough that if I put only one trash bin outside and if it's a recycle day, then it notifies me to put the other one too. Isn't it awesome? Yep. This also works if I don't put the trash bins back in its place on Saturday.
Ah, I know. You liked it. So what do we need to get this right? I'm assuming you have the Home Assistant installed already. If not, do check out the link above for complete tutorial on installing the Home Assistant. The hardware we need is ESP8266 board. This is a microcontroller and we can use this to connect it to the Home Assistant. An ultrasonic sensor. This basically is a distance sensor and it will calculate the distance between this sensor and the object in front of it. Jumper cables. This is just to avoid the soldering part, but hey, if you are a pro on soldering, please solder them. And this will be used to connect the ultrasonic sensor and the board, and a micro USB cable to load the software and also power up the board. Make sure the USB cable is data transfer supported. I'll give you more details about it later in this video. Once you have the hardware, we will do this in 5 steps: installing the ESP Home on Home Assistant, wiring up the board, loading the ESP Home onto the board, testing the values reporting from the board in the Home Assistant, and then the final part is creating an automation using these values to send us the notifications. Let's jump right into the first step. Once you have the Home Assistant loaded, click on the settings, click on add-ons, and click on add-on store, and then search for ESP Home, and then click install. The installation is going to take a little bit of time depending on the speed of the server and the internet. Okay, now the installation is done and now click on the watchdog. This will restart the add-on if it crashes, and also make sure you select the auto update and then also in the show in sidebar. Because we are going to use this add-on multiple times in our Home Assistant, I'm gonna put it in the sidebar and then click on start. What this will do is it will start this server inside the Home Assistant and give us the URL for the web UI. Once it is initialized, you can either click on the ESP Home on the sidebar or click on Open Web UI. And this will launch the dashboard of the ESP Home. Once you have the ESP dashboard opened, now we need to load the ESP Home onto the board. For that, click on New Device, and then it shows a pop-up saying that HTTPS is not enabled. So for this, we are going to have like two types of installations here. We can choose one with the Nabucasa URL which has a HTTPS enabled already and if you are subscribed to it, but if not, I'm gonna show you how to do it on the ESP Home Web. So click on Open ESP Home Web and then click Connect, and it is going to show the list of the USB ports that are connected to this machine, and right now it doesn't have anything. So I'm gonna connect the board using the USB cable, and now it is showing the new device. So select that new USB device and then click on Connect. Now you can see that it's connected, and click on the prepare for first use and click on install. So now it is trying to connect to the device and installing the ESP Home onto this board. And it says configuration is installed. Now click close, and then it is asking us if we want to connect it to the Wi-Fi. So I'll click on connect to the Wi-Fi and then choose the Wi-Fi name and then give the password. So what this will do is it will put the Wi-Fi credentials inside the board, and then the board tries to connect using the Wi-Fi from now on. And now click connect. So it says provisioned successfully. Now click on the visit device and you can see the IP address that is locally attached to our Wi-Fi. Now go back to the ESP Home dashboard, and now you can see there is a device that is showing automatically it was discovered by the Home Assistant, click on adopt. Once you click on adopt, it is asking for the name. You can give the trash pickup sensor and click on adopt. So this has created a configuration successfully and it is giving us an encryption key. Just copy that for now and then click on install. So now it's connecting to the device and installing the configuration needed to connect it to the home assistant. This is going to take some time, and once it is done, we will have it connected successfully to the home assistant. So now we can see that the configuration is successfully compiled and uploaded it to the board using the OTA method, which is over the air. And now click on stop. Now you can see that it's online, and then click on edit now to add the configuration to the YAML file. But before adding the configuration to the YAML file, we need to wire the boards. So grab the device and jumper cables. I need 4 of them, and it should be female to female, and also the ultrasonic sensor. Let's start with connecting the ultrasonic sensor. So connect these 4 wires, make sure they're tight enough. So once we connect the 4 wires to the ultrasonic sensor, the other side of the jumper cable to the device. So you can see on the device, it's gonna say VIN and GND. VIN is for the power that is passing, and the ground. So even on the ultrasonic sensor, you can see that there's a VCC that goes to the VIN on this board. So I have purple cable to the VCC, and there's also a pin called ground. So that goes to the ground on the board. So I have a black cable that goes to the ground. The trigger and echo are the pins that are pending. But before we connect those, let's go back to the configuration file. Open up the esphome.io and go for the distance sensor and click on the ultrasonic sensor that we are using. In the ultrasonic distance sensor, we have an example configuration entry. So let's copy that and then go back to our configuration file and then paste it there. So now we can see that the trigger pin and echo pins are D1 and D2, but they're showing some error here. So let's fix that first. When you look at the ESP board, Home Assistant doesn't automatically detect the actual board that we are using. So let's modify it to what we are using. You can also check these board types on the ESP Home website. Let's go back to the ESP Home website and then go to the home page. And then you can see the boards. So ours is ESP8266, and when you click on that, the board is going to say Node MCU V2. So that's what we are using now. And you can see that the errors disappeared on the trigger pin and echo pin. So now it says that we need to connect the trigger pin to the D1 and the echo pin to the D2. So the wires coming from the ultrasonic sensor, we have, at least I have, that trigger is a gray wire, and that goes to the D1, and the echo pin goes to the D2. So I'm gonna connect this to the D2. So once we have this connection successfully, go back to the configuration file and then click on install. So now it is going to ask you if you want to do the installation wirelessly or plug into the computer. From now on, we can use a wirelessly function. So it's gonna update everything on the OTA. So it's gonna compile with the new configuration and then load it onto the device. Now it says successfully uploading. Now it's trying to connect to the ESP home again. If you see error resolving IP address, don't freak out, because it is actually restarting, and then it's gonna try again to connect it. And once the device is available online, it's gonna connect it to the automatically. And now we can see that we have a Wi-Fi signal showing how much strength it has. Now we can see that there's a log saying that distance measurement timed out. That's because it was placed directly onto the table, and now we need some distance between the sensor and the table. So I'm just gonna point out this way, and then it's going to show us the accurate distance. And also, please be noted that the interval of updating this distance is every 60 seconds. And now we can see that the distance we got is 0.30 meters, and it's working perfectly. And also, we can change the interval of this distance reporting to the home assistant to even 2 seconds. Let's do that so that we can test it very quickly. Now click on stop and then go back to the configuration, and in the sensor add an entry called update interval, and then make it as 2 seconds, and then now install wirelessly. It's gonna compile everything again and then prepare a file to upload it to the board over the air. So it successfully uploaded the file to the board, and now the board is restarting and it's gonna reconnect it again. And now we can see the data that is being reported very quickly every 2 seconds. Let's test this out by placing a hand in front of the distance sensor, and now it's changing. I'm actually moving the hand far from the distance sensor and the distance is increasing. So this is accurate. Now click on stop. So what we have right now is we have ESP Home installed on the home assistant and loaded the ESP Home onto the board, also connected all the wires, and we are getting the reading from the distance sensor. So now we can use this data in the home assistant to create automations. Let's go back to the settings, click on devices and services. Now you can see there's a new device that was discovered. Click on configure and then submit. It's gonna ask for the encryption key. So let me grab that encryption key by going to the ESP Home. Click on edit. And then you can copy this encryption key inside the configuration YAML file and then enter it here. So this is how Home Assistant can communicate with the device using this encryption key, and click on submit. Now it is asking to which room we want to add. So I'm gonna keep it as garage and click on finish. And now let's open this device by clicking on the ESP Home and trash pickup sensor. Click on the device. So now it says ultrasonic sensor and the value is unknown. That's because it's pointed to the ceiling again. Now if we change this, and now it's gonna report to us the actual distance. So now we can see that Home Assistant is successfully reading the data from the distance sensor. Let's try and create the automation. So click on plus here for the automations, or you can go to the settings and then automations and scenes and click on create automation. Let's start with an empty automation. So how this automation works is we are going to place a distance sensor onto the wall and put the trash bins in front of it. So it will calculate the distance and detect if the bins are in its place. Let's start creating this automation. Click on add trigger and choose the time pattern and make it as 30 minutes. In my case, I'm trying to evaluate the distance between the bin and the sensor every 30 minutes past hour. I'm adding 30 minutes here, and then click on add condition and choose the time. The reason I'm adding time in two places is because Home Assistant doesn't allow us to add a weekday on the trigger here. So in the condition, we can put the fixed time, and I want it to be after 6 p.m. and before 11 p.m. and only on Thursdays, because my trash pickup is on Friday and I want to put the trash bins outside on Thursday evening. And also we need to add one more condition, which is the distance between the sensor and the trash bin. So click on the device and then choose the trash pickup sensor, and current trash pickup sensor's value should be 0.6 meters, I believe, which roughly translates to 2 feet. You don't have to put the trash bin at the same place because we are going to have some buffer, and make sure you put the distance between the wall and the midpoint of the trash bins. Once we have configured the trigger and the conditions, the next step is to add the notification. So we can send the notification to the Alexa devices or the phone. But for the sake of this demo, I'm going to add it to the phone and click on add action and then call service. And in the service, I'm gonna choose my iPhone, and the message can be anything. So I have added the message, and also I'll put some title here as trash pickup notification. We have successfully configured everything in the automation. Let's test each module of this automation. So the first one is I'm gonna test the time condition, and since it's Tuesday for me, I'm gonna add Tuesday for the sake of this demo, and then 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. and then try to run this one just to make sure it is working. And it says condition passes, so which is working. I'm gonna revert this back to 6 p.m. and then remove the Tuesday. Yeah, that works. The next one is current trash pickup sensor with ultrasonic, so it should be below 0.6. Right now it is pointing towards the ceiling, which is more than 0.6. So click on test, and the condition did not pass. and I'm pointing it to the table and try to run it again, and the condition passes, meaning that it is working. Let's test the action. Click on these three dots and then click run. So let me pull up the phone here and click on run, and you can see that the notification is successfully sent. So the final step is to save and add this as trash pickup notification. So this automation is to put the trash bins outside, but also on Friday, once the trash is picked up, we want to be notified to put the trash bins back in its place. So for that, click on these three dots and then duplicate the same automation, because we are going to use most of these. And in this new automation, the time pattern is going to be again 30 minutes, and the time condition is on Friday evening instead of Thursday evening. And then the trash pickup should be, if it is above 0.6, opposite of what it did before. And then again, the notification is, and I'm gonna add the notification message as, this message can be a notification to the phone or any text to speech message on your Alexa devices, which can be really funny. And then hit save and name this automation as put the trash bins back in their place. So this is how you create the automation inside the Home Assistant using the ultrasonic sensor. In a similar way, you can improve this automation by calculating the distance between the sensor and the recycling bin 2, which is placed next to the actual bin, and then notify yourself saying that, hey, today it's a recycling day and the other bin also needs to go out. And this automation needs to have an extra condition that needs to run on alternate Fridays. And like I promised, the other three ideas that you can use to implement this ultrasonic sensor to different use cases are, the first one, to calculate the distance between your car rooftop and the sensor that is hooked up to the ceiling of the garage or garage door opener. And this way, you can actually know if the car is inside the garage or outside and notify yourself at the end of the night saying that you need to put the car back inside the garage. And the next idea is to calculate how close you are to the wall when you're parking the car. So this can be achieved using an LED and the same distance sensor. So you can put the distance sensor and then calculate the distance between the car and the sensor. And when it is less than 1 foot or 1.5 feet, depending on your preference, you can switch on the LED automatically using the Home Assistant. And the last one, but not least, so the third idea is to get notified when the salt level is too low in the salt bin for the water softener. So you put this sensor to the lid of the bin and then calculate the distance between the salt level and get notified on the phone. So this way, you can get the salt bags before it gets too low. If you have made it this far in this video, thanks a lot. And if you want me to implement any of the ideas that I have given in the end of the video, please let me know in the comments below. I can make that happen. Thank you. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like this video. It means a lot to me. Thank you so much again.